Yeah, I've really, really enjoyed it. Been thrown in the deep end of the pre-season. The girls have been in for about 3 weeks before me. I've been away with, doing some Welsh stuff. But yeah, we've hit the ground running. Really, really intense. But there's no stone being left unturned. Really, really organised, really professional. And yeah, everybody's absolutely lovely. So yeah, enjoying it so far. So our main training days, on the two or three main training days, we do everything from strength and conditioning. We'll do video, we'll do homework tasks in between everything. Everything's already written up on the board. Some long and intense conditioning blocks thrown in between drills, which is great because I think that's what will separate separate us from the rest, building that physical and mental resilience, but also then having to execute our skills and decision-making pressure under fatigue for the rest of the session. So yeah, that's how I like it. It's super intense, and yeah, you can just imagine we're just really, really focused on drawing any knowledge and wisdom out of Liana Leota and the other management team. So yeah, it's fun. Yeah, it's been a bit crazy. I only passed my driving test in April, and I've been up and down the M1 I don't know how many times from Cardiff to Leeds. So yeah, I've yet to do it without being diverted off for road work. So that journey is long, and I'm glad it's over and I can just stay up here and really just immerse myself in everything to do with training, all the bits in between. There's no rest, so even on days where we're not actually together in training, there's always homework tasks, there's always stuff that we can be doing to just tick off those one percenters, just so that when February comes and those pre-season matches come, then we can really consolidate those connections. Obviously, we've still got a couple of players missing, so it's actually really exciting, the connections we've built already, still knowing that we've got quality players to come in from January as well, from South Africa. So yeah, I've been really engaged in looking at what the guys have been doing at Fast Five. Obviously El, Page and Nicola had awesome tournaments there. So yeah, it's just really exciting time to be part of Leeds Rhinos.
There's some familiar faces for you and some new faces. How do you feel like the team bond is going? Obviously it's just been a short time, but you've come into it. Do you feel like there's a connection already?
Yeah, it's weird. I feel like, I don't know, I think because you play against people, you know, we have done for a number of years, actually, it's just, you just hit the ground running. You sort of know each other's game. So it's just been really exciting to actually be on the same team as those people. And yeah, just start learning about people's range and skills on court, but also how people respond to different things off court. That'll be a huge strength for us if we can actually suss that out by the time the season starts. We'll know what each other needs on and off the court. We can embrace everybody's strengths and hopefully fit everything together and yeah, be firing once it comes to game time.
And alongside your playing, you're also going to be working with Leeds Rhinos Foundation.
Yeah.
Just finding your feet. Now, can you just tell us what kind of things we'll be expecting in the community? That's something obviously we want to strengthen at the club.
Yeah, I've had some good meetings with Gareth Cook from the foundation and a couple of others, Dan Busfield, and there's just such a buzz around the club. I had a tour of Headingley Stadium today and I heard about all the work they do. Fantastic work in the community, but also with local charities as well. The first task, we want to really nail down those Rhinos camps. I've heard they've been really well attended in the past, and actually we really just want to drive that, get as many kids but also adults. We're looking at some adult stuff and maybe some coach education stuff as well, to really just grow netball in the Yorkshire area. You know, I'm old enough to remember Leeds Carnegie and Yorkshire Jets, and I know how much of a thirst for team sports there is in this area. So yeah, I'm excited to be a part of that. And you know, we've said that there's a huge link between the netball club, the rugby league club, but actually the people in this local area, and we really want to strengthen that and grow that. So yeah,
one of those team bonding things you're doing is a little bit unusual to start with.
I know you're going to ask me about
this. To support the Rhinos Foundation.
Yeah.
What you, the guys have volunteered for.
Well, I thought Wales was cold. It is freezing up here. It's quite sunny though, but yeah, I mean, when Liana asks you to do something, you don't really want to say no. So when she said, will you sleep outside with me for a night in the terraces of Headingley Stadium, you can't really say no. I also live 5 minutes from there, so I've got no excuse. Might be able to pop home for a cup of tea, I don't know. But yeah, it's called The Big Sleep. I think they've got over 200 people signed up so far. And I think the proceeds that we will manage to raise from that will go to various local charities assigned to the club. So yeah, I haven't actually got a sleeping bag. So if anybody wants to volunteer any blankets for me, I'll take them on board.
Perfect.